The twin towers of the World Trade Center in New York stood 110 stories tall. Given what is known about rubble piles, we would expect the pile for each tower to be about 12% of its original height. 12% of 110 stories equals 13.2 stories.
All that's standing are the Twin Towers right now in the background. That's all that's standing. That's it. That's all that's left. And it's just gouged. Like, the parts of the Twin Tower just gouged out the building. That's the concourse below. That's going down like 20 feet or so. But that's the part that's crazy. It's just that's all that's left.
I'm I got hit initially with a blast of hot air, and I truly expected a fireball to be coming next. I expected to be incinerated in the street.
What the heck? Just put a few random fires in there, maybe some damage, and you saw the towers, they just fall straight down. And you better patent that one real quick before somebody else thinks about it. You know, just some random fires in the building, hey, it'll come straight down, it's great.
And then all of a sudden, it happened all over again. I just know something else hit us to the floor. Right in the basement, you felt it, walls were caving in, everything that was going on.
That's the all that's standing of the Twin Towers right now in the background. That's all that's standing. That's it. That's all that's left.
So you're literally right inside. What time did you actually photograph?
I don't even know. That was actually, I rode my motorcycle right up from there. That was about an hour ago. Not even.
And this is right at the center of where the Trade Towers stood.
You can see, like, when you see the firemen, there's nothing they can do. It's just, like, amazing.
You must have been frightened at the very least to be there.
I mean, I was just thinking to myself what a powerful act of ignorance it was, really. It's amazing.
And this is the building adjacent to...
That's the Twin Towers, right? That was the Twin Tower. That was the other tower. And then we went up into more into there.
You know, I just thought to myself, I can smell it, but in fact, what I can do is smell your shirt.
Yeah.
You brought the smell of just disaster with you on your T-shirt. Were there other people in there? I don't see anybody sort of.
I was with one other person I ran into there, who actually somebody I know, and he was photographing as well. And that was just us two and the firemen. It's funny, I ran into my friend right there who's also taking pictures. He should be somewhere. They probably edited him out.
It's absolutely...
Look at that. That's all that's left.
Do you know whether that's the South Tower or the North Tower?
That's the South Tower.
And you saw no sign of life in here whatsoever?
No, I went all the way right there. Like, I don't know if they edited it out yet, but there's a big hole going down to the ground. There's nobody. And then we ran into somebody else because they haven't seen anybody. Nobody. But the fireman said, you know, that there's been a lot of people dead, like a lot of firemen died.
Because there were firemen in the building at the time trying to help people evacuate from the building.
Yeah, they said 200 people died. I thought the fireman I saw too said 200 people died already.
And this wall here, this is from part of the tower itself?
Yeah, that's the South Tower, the lobby. And it's all the smoke and there's still fire going on in there right now.
Are you walking across?
Yeah, see,
you're walking across, and that's your friend also with a photograph. And the building on the right that occasionally appears in a building adjacent?
Yeah, and it's just gouged. Like, the parts of the Twin Tower just gouged out the building. See, that's the concourse below. That's going down like 20 feet or so. But that's the part that's crazy. It's just that's all that's left.
So. Did you hear anything while you were in there?
Just like cracklings and pops and stuff. See, that's the guy who's been looking for his friends, and he didn't find anybody either.
And do we know who this person is?
No, he was speaking Russian.
Really? Looking through the devastation. And this now is what?
This is a party, actually, so.
Last night?
No, it's a while ago, but.
Well, where was the party in?
That was in PS1.
Oh. So you just simply decided to go in there to see what you could photograph.
Yeah, I wanted it because I...
Another development on Saturday, New York officials revealed at a news conference here in the city that a hijacker's passport was found blocks from the World Trade Center crash site, if you can believe that.
Go low to the corner.
Let's go.
Three, two. Oh, man. More debris falling from a nearby building, the World Trade Center. We're at West Broadway and Barclay. Very difficult to breathe here, but look around. This must have been ground zero where this thing blew up. Car after car after car, buses completely obliterated and burned straight down to the steel. Behind me.
Keep your eye on that building. It'll be coming down.
The building is about to blow up. Moving back.
All right, guys.
We are walking back. There's a building about to blow up. On flame. Debris coming down.
Just in the last few seconds, another building, building number 7, one of the buildings in support of the World Trade Center towers, has collapsed. This is no small building, as you can see, at 47 stories. It would stand out in most American cities.
That's the part that's crazy. It's just that's all that's left.
So. Did you hear it?
It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.